Hey guys, today I'm going to share my biggest insecurity, and that is sharing my singing voice. Almost no one has heard me sing, and that's because what I really struggle with is getting rid of the tension that I have in my jaw, neck, upper shoulders, and chest. And for a long time, I didn't know what the source of this was. Then I went to two, maybe three different vocal coaches. One when I was in high school, another one a couple years ago, and another one like a year or two after that. Okay, the timeline might be wrong, but that doesn't matter. But what does matter is me realizing that the different techniques that I've tried to get rid of tension, like different vocal exercises, has not worked for me because the source of my tension is connected to my childhood trauma and the trauma that I experienced in my adulthood due to the childhood trauma. Basically, the big stem of it all is my childhood trauma. And I realize this is something that I need to work with my therapist on, because we tried EDMR during one of my sessions, but I really didn't understand what she meant when she said that I have to be in a very steady place, because EDMR just brings up a lot of anxiety past the session. So for me, the couple days after were very stressful, and I felt like I was back to where all the, you know, negative things happened. It felt like I was living in that memory, but after those three very difficult days, it just got a lot easier. Like, it was like I released it all, but there were just more present concerns that I had that I wanted to address. But now, so I had a session today, and when I go back, I'm going to discuss with her what I'm sharing with you guys now. Again, I just need help getting rid of that last oomph that I feel. It prevents me from singing at my full potential. It makes me doubt myself, and then I just don't sing confidently. And another thing that I'm going to start working on is strengthening my lower abs. The most successful, or most success I had with the vocal coach was when I was in Florida with the teacher named Alice, and she really emphasized that I needed to strengthen my lower muscles. And something that was different with her was that she pointed out that she wanted to teach me how to sing in general, not just how to sing specific songs. And I noticed myself getting a lot better with her. And she didn't have me practice singing in my off time, like when I wasn't with her, which was something different, because she mentioned she didn't want me to learn bad habits, which was fair because I was picking up a lot of bad habits. I just kept having my voice trapped in my throat, and that makes it hard to sing in a healthy way, higher notes. But I did the exercise, which I'm going to start doing again, and also I looked up YouTube videos for how to strengthen abs or ab workouts for singers, and that's something that I'm going to work on every single day, because singing is something that's very important to me. This is something that a lot of people don't know. I shared with Drew that I'm interested in making music. He's never heard me sing. Yeah, that's actually the last step. I finally figured out what kind of sound I want to go for. But I need help with that end. Like, I can hear it in my head, but I don't play instruments and I'm not a producer, so I'm just putting out into the universe and hoping the universe aligns in a way that the right people, compatible people, will enter my life, and then we can make something beautiful together. But in the meantime, I need to fully work on myself. And I've been dealing with past traumas, I've been dealing with bad habits, I've been dealing with, you know, just taking the steps necessary to be the best version of myself possible for myself, for my relationship, and for my family, the comedian family, and then so on. But a really big part of that is learning to have confidence in my voice. And again, the two main things that I'm working on is strengthening my core and getting rid of the last tension I have that keeps me holding back. And I think therapy is really going to help with that. But also, I'm going to face my fear and start sharing covers. Oh my gosh, that's so scary to say. I'm going to share covers of me singing with the strong caveat. Sorry, I'm just nervous. I'm babbling. But the first handful of videos probably are not going to be good because I'm going to be singing with the tension that I'm talking about. And it's very discouraging because I don't know what it is, but there have been times where I've just been able to let down my guard and just sing. Usually, if I record myself singing, I'm thinking about the fact that I'm recording myself, and I'm just like, I want it to be perfect, and then the tension gets back, and then it's not pretty. Let me say that. But I'm just hoping, just kind of like when I started making YouTube videos, my first handful of videos, and honestly a little bit more than that, or a little cringy to watch. I used to have like a Patreon ad at the end of my videos. I don't do that anymore, but that's awkward. Like, it's so awkward to watch, and I feel like that's what it's gonna be like for my first handful of videos. But the same way that I've gotten a little bit comfortable, that might probably be debatable, but I've gotten comfortable, I think, talking in front of the camera. If you think I'm still awkward, this is just who I am as a person. You just think I'm awkward, which is fine, but I digress. It's really hard to talk about because this is something that I'm very passionate about, and what brings up the biggest insecurity is knowing that I'm not at my full potential yet, which honestly I'm deciding that is actually an exciting thing, because it's not like I'm terrible, but I'm not where I want to be before I start recording music and songs. So what I feel like I need to do is just, I'm gonna say it once more, work on strengthening my core and work through therapy to get rid of this last burden I feel, and just really realizing what happened to me was not my fault, and there's no obligation for me to make space for that person in my life, period. Regardless of what other people might think or feel, that's just for me. And I think this will help me kind of trust myself more and trust in my capabilities and trust that I don't have a terrible voice. And more so, I use my voice as a way to tell the different stories that I want to tell and share, which is, I'll make a whole video on that. But I just really wanted to share with you guys that, again, I will be making videos of me singing. Be patient. Again, the first couple probably gonna be a little cringy, but I really think that just putting myself out there and facing this fear head on is what's gonna make me better. And also, I think this is a part of my healing journey. And if I just sit around waiting for my voice to just get better, it's not gonna happen. And I think it could be a source of encouragement for other people who feel insecure about their voice, who like me have gone and tried to get help. And I've had teachers that didn't believe in me because the sound coming out was so bad. And I didn't realize at the time what was going on, but there was just so much stress in my life. And I was just so depressed, and I didn't fully realize everything that happened to me. I still had a lot of it suppressed. But yeah, just knowing, just because, like, if singing is something you're really passionate about, okay, bye, Pixie. I just want to show my journey through finding my voice and finding confidence behind my voice. And hopefully, you know, it'll go from the awkward cringiness that it's going to begin with my early videos, to who who knows what it's going to turn into, but I do have a lot of confidence that it's going to turn into something beautiful. But I really do just need help in letting go of, you know, the last trickles. I don't even know what to describe it as. It's just, I still feel pain and hurt. I struggle to cry. I don't know how to cry. Whenever I feel the urge to cry, I just have an strong instinct to just hold it in. And I truly feel there's going to be a correlation between me learning how to cry more easily and me letting my voice just flow out when I sing. But in the meantime, you guys can be brutally honest about what you think about my singing, because, you know, that's just life. People share their opinions and they're not always nice. That's fine. But what I would appreciate even more than that is if you have feedback or tips or methods or strategies of strengthening your voice, or if you have core exercises you recommend for me to like really help engage my core when I sing so I'm not stuck in my throat, please share them with me. If you notice while I'm singing in my videos, you know, things I can do to improve, please share that, because this is something that I truly am passionate about, and this is something that I truly feel I can contribute to other people, not just by sharing my story through my videos, but through song. You know, just music, it resonates messages in a different level and wavelength, if you want to be all whatever, but yeah.